Bonjour, mon nom est Patrice Harvey, je suis artisan propriétaire chez Smart Race Paint tout près de Québec. Ce vlog a pour but de montrer le travail que je fais maintenant depuis presque 30 ans. Je peins et je personnalise des casques pour des pilotes de course automobile et ce, dans mon atelier ici, comme j'ai dit, tout près de Québec. Not bad for a bilingual introduction. I wanted to do this French introduction for a while now because, yeah, my main speaking language, the language I was born and raised into, is French, and I can't deny it. So, yes, I tried to hide it as much as possible, but I'm sure you guys knew it. So voilà. I can, if you want, guys, I can speak with a big French accent, but that's going to be very, very bad. Okay. in this episode, I'm gonna try and finish the two helmets that I started in the last episode. The reason I have to show the painting process over two episodes is that with all the masking and the drying time, I like to keep my videos to around 15-20 minutes, and with the level of videos that I want to make and the details that I want to show, it's impossible to show you guys the whole painting process of a helmet inside of one video without losing quality of the video. So this is why this is a concession that I make. I start helmets on one episode and then they continue to the next episode. All the while, everything is being filmed and then the edit is being done right before, you know, posting the videos on YouTube. So this is what this is how it's actually happening. On a week-to-week basis here, but basically I always have a camera pointed at my work and my hands, and I'm trying to film everything that I do so I can, you know, show you as much as possible of the process that I'm doing. Yeah, so I'm gonna try to finish that Italian helmet. This week we're gonna do gold leaf, which I've rarely done in my life. I'm not a specialist in gold leaf, full disclaimer. Will come later. And also we're gonna continue that carbon helmet, that carbon stilo helmet that I've been doing. This one is, as I speak, completed and done. So I'll have the video of that helmet at the end, all finished, all clear coated and done. Without further ado, let's get going. Time to get back to that carbon helmet. As you can see, I have repaired. What happened in last week's vlog had a little chip of clear coat that lifted. The whole thing has been re-varnished, re-clear coated, and then re-sanded. Now it's ready for another round of masking and painting and masking and painting. So let's do this. Thank you. literally just took me an hour and a half to sand the clear coat on that helmet. And then people ask, why is it so expensive to paint a helmet? Well, there you go. That hour and a half that I spent, well, you pay for it. Now, people will ask me, you know, hey, why don't you hire someone to do it? Well, been there, done that. The problem is, by working by myself and therefore not doing many, many helmets, if I were to hire someone, I would need to get in way more work, which means getting another person to paint as well. And I say been there, done that, is because I've tried it in the past. And of course, you can say you can hire good people, but you can never be better saved than by yourself. So my issue with getting someone to sand the helmet with me is that if there is a problem, one, I will see it right away. I won't have to investigate on who did it or what happened. I will see the problem and I will correct it right away. Now, and of course, if I'm the one doing it, you know, the possibilities of creating a problem in the first place, you know, during the sanding period, is minimized. So I'd rather do everything by myself and just forget about it, because it's way better than, you know, hiring someone. This being said, once in a while, my son Elliot, when he wants and he has free time from school, do prepare helmet, not the same thing. Sending clear coat like this is a bit tricky because you can't go through the clear and touch the paint. But preparing a brand new all white or all carbon helmet is another thing. You know, basically I remove all the parts, I prep the helmet, you know, I just mask the interior and I give the helmet to him and he will scuff the surface, get it ready for paint. That's very helpful, and once in a while he will give me a 2-3 hours and that helps a lot. Now, I've been accused of, you know, doing cheap child labor by doing this, but hey, come on, he's almost 14 now. He can work. La 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 One, two. Okay. I'm a bit nervous because I'm about to do something that I don't do very often, and it's gold leaf. And I'm not by any mean a specialist. I've done it like twice in my life. I've succeeded in doing it, but I'm not a specialist. So I'm gonna do it the way that I learned through internet and by asking questions to people. This helmet needs to have little gold pinstripe around the color block, the green and the red. So I need to put just a bit of glue and a bit of gold leaf in there. So let's hope, fingers crossed, everything goes well. Tape has been applied. Only the small pinstripe have been left unmasked. Time to apply the glue and hope for the best.